Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how to make an oval dome in SketchUp. All right, so there's a question on one of our videos that was asking how to make an oval dome, because we show in a few different videos how to make domes. So this is actually how to make an oval dome. And I started and I was like, yeah, actually this is a difficult thing. So I'm going to show you two different ways to do it. The first is kind of like a rough way that you can just get a dome. And then the second is how you get the literal shape of the dome. But it just takes a little bit more time. So let's say this is our building, right? And we want to put a dome roof on it. I'm going to make that a group. And then what I'm going to do here is make another circle. And then draw, this is like in our other video. Draw some lines here. Hit A for arc, choose my two endpoints. I hit this corner here and hit shift to lock so that I'm in that axis. And if you want to have like a bulgy sort of dome, you can certainly do that. This would be a little bulgier. I want it to be more round, so I'm just going to try to eyeball this. Looks pretty good. Delete this inner circle, select my path, choose the follow me tool, and select the shape. Okay, I'm going to reverse the faces here. I'm going to also make this a group. Now, place this here. Hit S for scale. Then I'm just going to scale it until it looks generally correct. Right? So this is what I'm saying. It's not exact, but it kind of gets the job done. This back part is maybe not the best, but you know, you could then put a parapet or something around this and it would hide the dome, because you're not going to have a dome that actually goes right to the edge in most cases. So like maybe it looks something like that, and that for your purposes might be fine. So it's just making a regular dome and then stretching it to become an oval, and if you wanted to flatten it out, you can certainly do that. I'm just going to copy that over to the side so we have both versions. And then I'm going to select the click into the shape, hit Control C for copy, and then copy this. So now I have that exact shape. Now I'm going to draw a line through the middle here. And I'm just going to draw a bunch of lines that connect across this point. Start in the middle. Connect with the midpoint, that go through the midpoint, right? So these, starting to see what's going on here. So a bunch of lines. This is pretty much for me, just so that I can see what is going on and I don't get too confused. So I have a bunch of these lines. And then how tall do I want it? Let's say this tall. And then you just start to draw your arcs. So you can see it's in the red axis here. So I'm just gonna hit the up arrow on my keyboard to lock to the blue axis. I get that guy. And then you just do that for all of these. I'm just gonna speed this up and then we'll come back after I'm finished. Okay, so now we have a bunch of those shapes, and I'm going to delete the inner portion. I'm just going to try to select these, not too carefully, but carefully enough. I just want the inner portions of these shapes gone. Okay, so I have a bunch of these. Now I'm going to select all these lines, go to Draw, Sandbox from Contours, and I now have that shape. And it makes a group automatically, so I can just move this. You can see that I have a shape here that fits right on my building. And if you want it to be less or more dome-like, then you can do that. My thoughts on this dome is that it might not be round enough for you. And so I'm going to show you a third way that you can do a dome. So we're getting three ways out of this. What I'm going to do here is just copy this off to the side. It's actually just Control C, edit, paste in place, and then push pull this up so that I have another shape on here. Hit M, select that face, and then hit M to move. Then move it all the way down, and then hit the forward slash. We're going to do 5. So now I have 5 instances of that shape through here. Now I'm going to select this, hit S for scale, and then select one of these corners, and I'm holding the Control key so that it scales uniformly in all directions. And then just sort of massage this so that it begins to look like what I want. So obviously with an arc, at the very top is the smallest. So let's do something like that maybe. And then move this down. So hit the up arrow. So that's more dome-like. Now you have these lines here, so if you hit E for the eraser tool and then control click on each of them, it'll smooth out that line and hide it. So now I have a dome here. And obviously you can see the facets that go around. The more lines that you do, so I did 5 in this case, but the more that you do, the smoother it will look. So hopefully this helped. If you liked this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.